Hello all. So we'll finish with the electrophilic addition to alkene, the second part of my presentation. So this is also the last part of my portion with all these reactions that we covered today. We'll finish the entire organic chemistry portion from my side. So we had already started with electrophilic addition to alkene. In the part one of the video, you had seen certain reactions where you added bromine across the double bond, you added HBr across the double bond, you added water across the double bond. So now, continuing with the same concept of electrophilic addition to alkenes, we'll see certain reactions today, namely oxymercuration, demercuration, hydroboration oxidation, oxidation of alkenes to epoxides, ozonolysis, periodate cleavage, and alkenes reaction with NBS. So all these reactions are there. None of the mechanisms of any of these reactions have to be done. The mechanisms are never asked in your exam. They only ask to predict the product and only the reaction. So the mechanism is not asked. So we'll directly look upon the reactions, all these reactions, with some solid examples as well. And we'll also touch up on the concept of regioselective, stereoselective, and stereospecific. So first we'll start with the concept of regioselective. So regioselective is nothing but regio meaning region, selective meaning the reaction is going to happen at a particular region. So the prime example is anti-Markovnikov rule and Markovnikov rule. So as per the Markovnikov rule, you know that hydrogen is added to a carbon which is already hydrogen rich. So this hydrogen in Markovnikov is going to go on this carbon itself. So it is going and adding on a particular carbon on a particular region only. That is why this is also called as a regioselective reaction. Same goes with anti-Markovnikov. Exactly opposite happens. The hydrogen goes to that carbon which has the least number of hydrogens, which is this. So here it is confirmed that the hydrogen will react on this carbon at this region only. That is why this is also a regioselective reaction. Second is something called a stereoselective. Stereoselective meaning the stereochemistry of the product will be selective due to whatever reasons. So here another reaction, the alkene is going to get epoxide formation across the alkene. Here meaning a double bond O, a cyclic epoxide is going to be formed. Here you can see the major stereoisomer is in this form where the attack is on the least hindered face, whereas the minor stereoisomer is going to be formed, but it will be minor because there will be some steric hindrance involved. Here the steric hindrance is the least, that is why this isomer is preferred. So that is why it is selective. You will get both the products. So that is why it is not specific. It is not telling you that exactly one product is going to be formed. No, you're going to get a mixture of products, but it will tell you which is major, which is minor. That is why it is called a stereoselective. So one of the isomer is selectively more forming over the other isomer. That is why stereoselective. The next concept is stereospecific. Stereospecific meaning exactly one isomer is going to be formed. The prime example here is again epoxide formation, but on a cis. So if the compound itself, if the starting material is cis configuration, your epoxide will also be in a cis formation. If your starting material is in a trans formation, your final product will also be in a trans conformation. So that is why it is specific. You're only getting one exact product with exact stereochemistry. That is why the name stereospecific. So this is the prime difference between regioselective, stereoselective, and stereospecific. These terms will be used quite a few as we go ahead in this chapter. So the first reaction that you're going to learn is oxymercuration, demercuration. Oxymercuration, demercuration happens in the presence of two reagents. One is your mercuric acetate in the presence of water and your NaBH4. NaBH4 is a strong reducing agent. Mercuric acetate. So across the double bond, your mercuric acetate is going to be attached, which will be replaced by your H eventually, and this water is going to add your OH. So eventually this reaction is nothing but the formation of alcohol. Oxymercuration, demercuration, alkene gets converted to alcohol. That is what you have to remember. oxymercuration, demercuration is a reaction of converting alkenes into alcohols. That is the crux of the reaction. The mechanism you need not study. It is complex. The reaction is regioselective and stereoselective. Regioselective meaning the reaction is going to happen on either of these two carbons. It can happen here or it can happen here. Stereoselective, selective meaning it can be anti-addition. Both the carbons here can form either a trans product or a cis product, depends. It is stereoselective. So now we'll see, but remember this reaction does not undergo rearrangements. Meaning if you remember the previous reactions that we saw, alkene with HBr, alkene with water, we used to do some alkyl shifts, some hydride shifts, some proton shifts, so that a tertiary carbocation is formed. Here, such rearrangements do not occur due to the presence of this mercuric acetate intermediate. That does not allow that rearrangement to take place. This is what you need to remember. If you know the reaction mechanism, then you will understand why it does not happen. But the reaction mechanism is not there in your portion, so forget about it. But why the rearrangement does not happen is because of the presence of your mercuric acetate intermediate, which does not allow that carbocation rearrangement to happen. Eventually, you are going to get a racemic product. Racemic product, mixture of enantiomers. So meaning across this double bond, on one carbon, OH is going to get attached. On the other carbon, H is going to get attached. On one carbon, OH is going to get attached. On the other carbon, H is going to attach. This reaction, oxymercuration, demercuration, is going to follow Markovnikov's rule. Markovnikov's rule state that hydrogen will go to that carbon which is already hydrogen rich. So if you take the example here, this carbon has how many hydrogens? It has only one hydrogen. Whereas this highlighted carbon has how many hydrogens? Two hydrogens. So as per Markovnikov rules, the hydrogen will be added to this carbon, that therefore the OH will be added to this carbon. So eventually you are going to get an anti-addition, that is confirmed. So if this OH is on a wedge here, so here the H will be attached, that will be on a dash. Here I have not shown, so it is assumed if the OH is on the wedge here, so here the hydrogen will be on the dash. This is one enantiomer. The other enantiomer that would be formed is the OH itself is on the dash. That means on the other carbon here, the highlighted carbon, there will be a hydrogen, but it will be on a wedge. So I hope you understood this reaction. Oxymercuration, demercuration is conversion of alkenes to alcohols. On one carbon, the OH is being attached. On the other carbon, hydrogen is being attached. This reaction follows Markovnikov's rule and it does not undergo rearrangements, and it gives a mixture of enantiomers and there is anti-addition. Anti meaning OH agar yahan par wedge pe hai, to yahan par hydrogen jo aayega, wo dash pe aayega. It is here, I have not just drawn it here, it is already here, H yahan par ek hai, but wo dash pe hai. Here, or you can get the other enantiomer where OH is on the dash and the hydrogen which is not seen here will be on the wedge. So we'll try to solve some examples. The mechanism I have already shown here. If you are interested, you can go through the mechanism. It's quite easy. It's quite simple to understand. But in the exam, the mechanism is not asked. So if you can, you want to ignore, you can ignore. So we'll see some solved example here. This is one starting material that they have taken. If you can see here, there is a primary carbon, there is a secondary carbon, there is a quaternary carbon. It is reacting with your mercuric acetate, water and NaBH4. So ideally, what should happen? Ideally, if you remember the OH, the water addition, the HBr addition, ideally what should have happened? Here, there could have been an alkyl shift, a tertiary carbocation would have been formed and the reaction would have happened. But as I said, in oxymercuration, demercuration, the rearrangement does not happen because there is no rearrangement, meaning directly the OH is going to get attached and the H is going to attach on these two carbons according to Markovnikov's rule. Here there are how many hydrogens? There is only one hydrogen. Here there are how many hydrogens? There are two hydrogens. So the hydrogen will be attached on this carbon. The OH will be attached on this carbon. So you will get an enantiomer, a racemic mixture. OH is on the wedge here. That means there will be a hydrogen on the dash here. Or you will get an enantiomer. OH is on the dash here. So H will be on the wedge here. Remember, there is no rearrangement. Another example here, they have given you this kind of reaction, this kind of starting material. Again, this is one carbon, this is another carbon. As per Markovnikov, here how many hydrogen? One hydrogen, here two hydrogen. So that is why the OH will attack on this carbon, the H will attack on this carbon. So you will get OH here on, say it is on wedge, for example, then there will be a hydrogen here on dash. And then there will be an enantiomer of this same product, meaning OH will be on dash and H will be on wedge. Another reaction here, here you can see both the carbons are secondary. So doesn't matter here, on one carbon there will be OH on wedge, so on other there will be H. Here they are from mercuric acetate, you can ignore this. This is nothing but hydrogen. Hydrogen here. That is the next step they have not shown here. There is nothing but hydrogen getting attached here. So if OH is on wedge here, H will be on dash here, or OH will be on dash here, H will be on wedge here. Here, please ignore this acetate. It is an intermediate. It will be replaced by hydrogen eventually. Another solid example. This is a little bit tricky. If you pay attention, this is an unsymmetrical alkene here. So if you can see, both these carbons are secondary carbon. So either OH can attack here or OH can attack here. It can attack on both the places. Why? Because both are secondary. So both places OH can attack. Let's first assume the OH is attacking on this carbon, this highlighted here. If the OH is attacking on this carbon, so the OH is going here, obviously the H will go here. The H will go here. But pay attention now, this carbon, this here is not a chiral carbon. Chiral carbon absent. If you can see here, this carbon is attached to an ethyl group and another ethyl group and a OH. Obviously, there is a invisible hydrogen already here, and there is also a hydrogen added from the reaction over here. Now, this central carbon is not chiral. If it is not chiral, obviously it will not give you an enantiomer. That is why you will only get this one product, where OH will be attacked here, the H will be attacked here. Only one product if the OH is attacked here. There can be also another product where the OH can be attacked on this carbon, this highlighted here. So if the OH gets attacked here, obviously the H will get attacked here. If the OH gets attacked on this carbon, this is a chiral carbon. That is why you will get an enantiomer. So if OH is on a wedge here, obviously the H will be on a dash here. Or you can get an enantiomer where OH is on the dash there and H will be on the wedge here. So you will get a mixture of three products in this particular reaction, in this particular example. Next second reaction we'll see today is hydroboration oxidation. It happens in the presence of borane, tetrahydrofuran, NaOH, hydrogen peroxide and water. This is also again a very similar reaction. Product is exactly the same. Alkene gets converted to alcohol. Alkene gets converted to alcohol. Only difference is the reagents. Borane, tetrahydrofuran, NaOH, H2O2 and water. It is also radioselective and stereoselective. Here there is syn addition. Syn addition meaning both the OH and H are going to get attacked on the same side. There is not going to be anti-addition here. There is going to be syn addition, meaning H and OH are going to be attacked on the same side. This reaction is going to follow your anti-Markovnikov's rule, exactly opposite. The hydrogen will go to that carbon which has less number of hydrogens, anti-Markovnikov rule. Again, this reaction does not undergo any rearrangement. Again, this same reaction is a racemic product, mixture of enantiomers. Only difference are the reagents, and it follows anti-Markovnikov rule, and there is syn addition, not anti-addition. Again, alkene is going to get converted to alcohol. We'll see some examples. Here they have taken an alkene here. If you can see here, there is a secondary carbon, there is a tertiary carbon. Here they have added BH3 twice, they have used B2H6. Doesn't matter, it eventually is going to give you syn addition and an alcohol. And one carbon there will be OH attached, on the other carbon there will be hydrogen attached. Where will the hydrogen be attacked now? Now remember, this reaction is going to undergo anti-Markovnikov. In this carbon, how many hydrogens? Zero hydrogens on this carbon. on this carbon, how many hydrogen? One hydrogen on this carbon. So your hydrogen will attack on that carbon which has less number of hydrogens, anti-Markovnikov rule. So your H will be attacked on this carbon. On this carbon, there will be OH attached. So this carbon will have OH, this carbon will have H attached, anti-Markovnikov rule. And it is a syn addition. Syn addition meaning either it could be both wedge-wedge, H and OH both could be on wedge, or you can get an enantiomer where H and OH both are on the dash. So these are the enantiomers that you are going to get, enantiomers. Syn addition, both on wedge or both on dash, following anti-Markovnikov rule. Third reaction that we'll see today is oxidation of alkenes to peroxides. Alkenes on reacting with a per acid gives you epoxide. These are stereospecific reactions. Specific meaning cis alkenes will give you cis products, cis epoxides. Trans alkenes will give you trans epoxides. Okay, so now what are these per acids? First, I will show you what are these per acids. Per acids are nothing but peroxy acids. Peroxy acid meaning an acid with an extra oxygen attached. So if you know what is a normal acid is RCOOH, but a peroxy acid will be RCOOOH. Three oxygens attached. So that is why this peroxy acid is extremely unstable and extremely reactive, because two oxygens next to each other in a single bond are extremely reactive. Peroxy acid. This is a prime example of a peroxy acid. This is an example, peroxy acetic acid. Here nothing but CH3. So CH3, C double bond OOH, peroxy acetic acid. Another peroxy acid which is quite famous is MCPBA, metachloroperbenzoic acid. So you know what is benzoic acid, benzene COH, meta pe chloro dal do, meta pe chloro dal diya. It is perbenzoic acid, meaning COOH will turn into COOOH, three oxygens attached. So this is also a peroxy acid, very famous, MCPBA, metachloroperbenzoic acid, or you can use peroxy acetic acid. Remember, it is a stereospecific reaction. Cis alkenes will form cis epoxide. Trans alkenes will form trans epoxide. So this I have taken a cis alkene. If it is a cis alkene, it will form a cis epoxide. Cis meaning these two bonds will be both dono wedge honge ya dono dash honge. So this is a trans alkene reacting with a per acid. So again there will be an epoxide form, but trans hoga. मतलब यहाँ पर एक वेज होगा तो दूसरा CH3 डैश होगा. एक CH3 डैश पे है, दूसरा CH3 वेज पे है. यहाँ पर दोनों CH3 या तो डैश पे रहेंगे या तो दोनों CH3 वेज पे रहेंगे. तो दिस इज सिस अल्कीन विल गिव सिस एपॉक्साइड, ट्रांस अल्कीन विल गिव ट्रांस एपॉक्साइड. दिस रिएक्शन इज कॉल्ड एज ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ अल्कीन्स टू फॉर्म एपॉक्साइड इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ परोक्सी एसिड, इधर परोक्सी एसिटिक एसिड और metachloro or benzoic acid. Next reaction we'll see is ozonolysis of alkenes. Ozonolysis meaning, it's quite easy, lysis meaning break, breakage of your alkene, breakage of your double bond in the presence of O3. O3 is nothing but ozone. Three kinds of breakages or lysis that are going to happen. One is in a reductive atmosphere, another is an oxidative atmosphere, another is in a very strong reductive atmosphere. The first is in a very mild reductive atmosphere. Reductive atmosphere in the presence of DMS, dimethyl sulfide. DMS is a mild reductive atmosphere that is given. What is going to happen here? This carbon, if you can see here, is a tertiary carbon. Tertiary carbon meaning carbon attached to three other carbons. So this here highlighted carbon is attached to 1, 2, and 3. Three other carbons. So that is why this is a tertiary carbon. This is a secondary carbon. Why is it called a secondary carbon? Carbon attached to two other carbons. This carbon is attached to here one carbon. This carbon is attached to another carbon. Two carbons are attached. It's called as a secondary carbon. So in such a reaction where there are both secondary and tertiary carbon in the presence of ozone and a mild reductive atmosphere, what is going to happen is the tertiary, tertiary carbon will get converted to ketone, whereas the secondary carbon will get converted to aldehyde. Remember, the tertiary carbon will get converted to ketone. The secondary carbon will get converted to aldehyde. There is going to be breakage. Exactly, a double bond hai. Yahan par aapka bond break hoga. Yahan par main highlight kar raha hu. Yahan par break hoga aapka bond. Yahan par tertiary carbon tha, wahan par double bond O aa jayega aur ek ketone form ho jayega. Jahan par secondary carbon tha, wahan par bhi ek double bond O aa jayega. But yahan par yaad rakho, yahan par ek HB tha pehle se jo abhi invisible hai. यहाँ पर एक aldehyde form हो जाएगा. This happens in the presence of mild reductive atmosphere. Second reaction is mild oxidative or in an oxidative atmosphere in the presence of H2O2. Hydrogen peroxide is also a strong oxidizing agent. So यहाँ पर क्या होता है? Here also same thing is going to happen. The bond is going to break here across the double bond. But this is an oxidation reaction. So the tertiary carbon will get converted to ketone. That is not going to change. But what is going to change? The secondary carbon will get converted to an acid. Why? Because there is a strong oxidizing agent. So, ye secondary, pehla kya ho jayega? Iska, it will get converted to aldehyde. But because of the strong oxidizing agent across here, the aldehyde will get further oxidized to an acid. So, what you are going to get? Tertiary carbon will get converted to ketone. Secondary carbon will get converted to acid in presence of an oxidative atmosphere. The last condition here is a very strong reductive atmosphere in the presence of NaBH4, very strong reducing agent. What's going to happen here? Yahan par bhi the bond is going to break across the double bond. Tertiary carbon is going to get reduced to alcohol. Secondary carbon is also going to get reduced to an alcohol. So these are three different types of ozonolysis. Reductive, first mild reductive atmosphere, kya hoga? Tertiary carbon gets converted to ketone, secondary carbon gets converted to aldehyde. Oxidative atmosphere, kya hoga? Tertiary carbon gets converted to ketone, secondary carbon gets converted to acid. Strong reducing agents या atmosphere क्या होगा? Tertiary carbon gets converted to alcohol, secondary carbon also gets converted to alcohol. So this is first example that we saw. This example had secondary and tertiary carbons. Now what if you have primary carbons? This reaction again, these two reactions are again the same reaction that I've just explained here. I have taken another example here of cyclohexene. Cyclohexene is the cyclic structure. So nothing to worry about cyclic structure. Which kind of carbon is this? This is again a secondary carbon. Secondary carbon in presence of H2O2. H2O2 matlab oxidative atmosphere. Secondary carbon. Kya hoga? Will get a acid formation. Secondary carbon. So both these carbons are secondary. Yahan par aapka bond break ho jayega. The cyclic molecule will now become a open chain molecule and yahan par bhi ek COOH form ho jayega. Sixth carbon pe bhi ek COOH form ho jayega. You can redraw this molecule and form a open chain because the bond is going to break. Your cyclic molecule is now going to be non-cyclic and straight chain. Aur kya hone wala hai? Both these carbons are secondary. Secondary carbon in presence of H2O2 forms acid. So after eventually you will form your two acids, diacidic molecule. Again, prime example here, another different example here I have taken. Here you have secondary carbon and you have primary carbon. Secondary and primary. Yahan par bond break hoga. What are the reagents involved? O3 diya hai, DMS diya hai. DMS meaning mild reductive. Mild reductive mein secondary ka kya hota hai? Mild reductive में secondary का होता है aldehyde. So this secondary carbon will break and form a aldehyde. Whereas ये जो एक carbon बचता है, carbon पे यहाँ पर क्या हो जाएगा? Double bond O. यहाँ पर एक oxygen जाके add हो जाएगा. You will get a ketone here eventually. Formaldehyde. This can also be CHO. This is nothing but formaldehyde. So secondary carbon DMS mild reductive gets converted to aldehyde. The other primary carbon left also gets oxidized to form aldehyde, which is formaldehyde. Same reaction in the presence of O3 and H2O2. H2O2 मतलब oxidative. Oxidative में secondary का क्या होता है? Oxidative में secondary carbon gets converted to acid. So if you can see here, secondary carbon got converted to COOH. Whereas in oxidative, the primary carbon CH2, the primary carbon will also get converted to acid. So remember, whenever there is H2O2 involved, all carbons, primary, secondary or tertiary. Here, if you can see H2O2 involved, only tertiary carbon gets converted to ketone. Secondary carbon gets converted to acid. And now we also saw the primary carbon also gets converted to acid. Next reaction is periodate cleavage. This is a quite basic, simple reaction of vicinal diols. Vicinal meaning the carbon next to each other, neighboring carbons have two OH groups attached. Vicinal diols are cleaved by periodic acid. HIO4 is periodic acid, leading to the formation of, there is a cleavage here between the two carbons, between the two vicinal carbons, and leading to the formation of two carbonyl compounds. Here the side chain could be anything. It could be CH3, it could be H, it could be C2H5, it could be anything, but you will get two carbonyl carbons plus HIO3 and water. The reaction is selective only for 1,2 diols. Reaction, this kind of cleavage of biperiodic acid is only given by 1,2 diols. The reaction occurs via formation of cyclic periodate ester. The mechanism is not required. This test can be used as a functional group test of 1,2-diol. So if there is their unknown compound contains a diol and you want to find out whether it is a diol only in your unknown compound, and you want to find out if it is a vicinal diol, react it with periodic acid, you will get a mixture of carbonyl compounds. Last is your alkenes with N-bromosuccinamide, also called as NBS. Alkenes with NBS, N-bromosuccinamide. Please pay attention. This reaction goes via free radical mechanism. The mechanism is not to be studied, but it goes via free radical mechanism. This reaction, NBS, only reacts on allylic carbon or benzylic carbon. Allylic carbon is the carbon that is adjacent to the alkene carbon. So if in this particular reaction, these two are the CH and CH, the alkene here. So this carbon, the next carbon is an allylic carbon. The hydrogen that is attached to that next carbon is called as allylic hydrogen. Your reaction is going to happen on allylic hydrogen. But remember, it happens via free radical mechanism. So resonance is also involved. So the first reaction, remember, is going to happen on allylic hydrogen. This reaction is nothing but an example of bromination. Matlab bromine add hone wala hai. Kahan par add hoga? We will see. First, bromine will get attacked on the allylic hydrogen. This is a symmetrical alkene. So ye wala bhi allylic hydrogen hai. Ye wala bhi allylic hydrogen hai. The reaction can happen on anywhere. So if you can see here, the first reaction is, yahan par the H gets replaced by Br. This is the first reaction that is going to happen. Second reaction is nothing but, यहाँ पर how does this reaction actually happen? This hydrogen पे यहाँ पर एक free radical form होता है, ये वाला जो आपको highlighted red दिख रहा है आपको यहाँ पर, this is nothing but a free radical, assume करो ये free radical का resonance होता है. Resonance meaning ये double bond यहाँ पर ये carbon के बीच में आ जाता है to compensate for this free radical, due to which ये अगर double bond यहाँ पर shift होता है तो radical को किधर आ जाएगा? यहाँ पर आ जाएगा. अगर radical यहाँ पर आ जाएगा, मीनिंग आपका यहाँ पर भी एक रिएक्शन होना पॉसिबल है. सो यू विल गेट टू प्रोडक्ट्स, वन ऑन द अलाइलिक हाइड्रोजन हियर, सेकेंड ड्यू टू रेजोनेंस द डबल बॉन्ड विल शिफ्ट हियर एंड यहाँ पर एक रेडिकल आ जाएगा, तो यहाँ पर भी एक ब्रोमीन अटैक होगा. योर डबल बॉन्ड, इफ यू कैन सी, हैज नाउ शिफ्टेड. सो दीज टू काइंड ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स यू विल गेट. दिस इज नथिंग बट अ ब्रोमिनेशन रिएक्शन. आपका नथिंग बट ब्रोमीन इज गोइंग टू गेट अटैक और अटैच्ड ऑन द अलाइलिक हाइड्रोजन और अलाइलिक कार्बन. अलाइलिक मीनिंग डबल बॉन्ड को जो डायरेक्टली कार्बन अटैच्ड है, दैट इज अलाइलिक कार्बन. वो कार्बन को आपका Br जाके अटैच होता है, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अल्केन्स रिएक्शन विद NBS, N-bromosuccinamide. another reaction I have taken here. This is a cyclohexene. यहाँ पर allylic carbon कौन से है? ये एक है allylic carbon और एक है ये allylic carbon. ये दोनों allylic carbon है, but याद रखो दोनों symmetrical है, तो आप कोई भी एक carbon पे reaction कर सकते हो. तो समझो मैंने reaction ये carbon पे किया. ये पहला, ये allylic carbon है, तो first product क्या form होगा? यहाँ पर एक Br आ जाएगा. So you can see here there is a Br formation here. Also, there could be resonance because of free radical forming here. So this double bond will come here to resonate with the free radical, जिसके वजह से ये carbon पे free radical आ जाएगा. So due to which there will be another Br adding here. So this is nothing but two kinds of products formed in your cyclohexene reacting with NBS. Another reaction. This is a little bit more complex. यहाँ पर भी cyclohexene है, but there is a methyl group attached here. Methyl group attached here. Here you are going to get a mixture of four products. Mixture of four products. Meaning यहाँ पर allylic carbon कौन से है? Same. यहाँ पर ये भी allylic carbon है. यहाँ पर ये भी allylic carbon है. यहाँ पर ये allylic carbon के पास एक hydrogen attached है. यहाँ पर ये allylic carbon के पास दो hydrogen attached है. So first let us assume ये वाला allylic carbon लेते हैं. तो अगर ये वाला allylic carbon पे रिएक्शन करना है, सो देयर विल बी Br अटैक्ड हियर डायरेक्टली. ये वाला allylic carbon पे रिएक्ट करोगे तो यहाँ पर एक फ्री रेडिकल आएगा, उसके साथ रेजोनेंस करने के लिए ये डबल बॉन्ड शिफ्ट होगा. अगर ये डबल बॉन्ड शिफ्ट हो गया तो यहाँ पर फ्री रेडिकल आएगा, और यहाँ पर अगर फ्री रेडिकल आया तो यहाँ पर भी ब्रोमिनेशन होगा. सो इफ यू यूज दिस allylic carbon, दिस हियर हाईलाइटेड हियर, यू विल गेट दीज टू प्रोडक्ट्स. नाउ लेट्स गो टू द अदर allylic carbon. इफ यू टेक दिस allylic carbon, first product will be formed here. यहाँ पर directly एक Br attack होगा. If you take this allylic carbon, there will be also resonance. The double bond will come down and यहाँ पर एक free radical आएगा. यहाँ पर free radical आएगा तो यहाँ पर भी एक Br attack होगा. So if you use this allylic carbon, you will get these two products. So total there are two allylic carbons and it is not symmetrical. That is why each and every allylic carbon will give you two products. So two allylic carbons, 2 × 2, total mixture of four products. So this is your reaction of alkenes with L-bromosuccinamide. It is a reaction where nothing but there is bromination happening. So these are your all reactions of electrophilic addition to alkenes. So these two videos that I've shared, one that I've shared previously 2-3 days back, and this video, with this the entire chapter of electrophilic addition to alkenes is over and I have completed my portion. If you have any doubts, go through this video again. This is not a very easy topic, especially what I taught today is a little bit tricky. So please go back, watch this video again and again, try to solve the sums again and again. If you have any questions in the solved examples, please feel free to contact me or call me directly. I will also send this PPT across. Thank you.